Hello everyone. Now, my attention was drawn to a recent Facebook poll by a friend of mine. Now, usually I tend to avoid these polls. They either tend to be rather banal, like, what day of the week is it, with opinion divided in seven different directions. Or they tend to be rather obvious, like, who's better, Busted or McFly, with the answer obviously being McFly. But this was curious. The question was, do you live in an odd-numbered house or an even-numbered house? Or to put it another way, what's the probability that you live in an odd-numbered house? Now, I'm going to give you a moment to think about that. What do you think it is? And, well, in the meantime, here's a picture of an orangutan and a kitten. Right, so what do you think it is? And what's the probability that you live in an odd-numbered house? Now, you might have thought that the probability was 50-50. In other words, the probability is 0.5. But it appears that the probability is slightly more than that, at 0.502. That means that you are slightly more likely to live in an odd-numbered house than an even-numbered house. But how come? When my attention had been first drawn to this poll, there had already been a quarter of a million responses. 250,000 responses. With the breakdown looking like this. And you can see that the number of odd-numbered houses was already starting to pull ahead by about 1,000. In fact, the proportion of odd-numbered houses was already standing at 0.502. But is this significant, or was it just down to chance? I mean, certainly, if I took a coin and I tossed it 250,000 times, I would expect the number of heads to turn up about half the time, 125,000. But there's no guarantee of that. You can get a run of good luck and end up with more heads than tails. In fact, it's even possible, although very unlikely, you can get 250,000 tails in a row. But if you perform the experiment repeatedly, you will end up with a bell curve centering around the mid-value, 125,000, with 95% of results turning up in the range 124,500 to 125,500. That's the middle 95%. You may have heard of this as plus or minus 2 standard deviations from the mean. Now, on the other hand, 5% of results will be outside this range. Now, these are going to be the more extreme results, but still perfectly normal. I mean, for example, if I perform the experiment 20 times and I get one result outside that range, that will be as expected. Now, the poll so far is outside this range. Now, that doesn't mean that the answer isn't 50-50. But it is evidence that there is a bias towards odd-numbered houses. Now, it doesn't confirm the bias, but it's just a failure to reject the idea that there is bias. A couple of days later, the poll had reached 400,000 responses, with the breakdown now looking like this. Now, that theoretical 95% interval gets more narrow with more responses. The proportion of odd-numbered houses here was still 0.502. So in fact, this was now falling even wider of the theoretical 95% interval. And if it was 50-50, I'd be expecting the opposite to happen. So why isn't it 50-50? Think about the number of odd-numbered houses in streets with an even number of houses compared with an odd number of houses. If your street has an even number of houses, then the proportion of odd-numbered houses will be 50%. It doesn't matter if your street contains 10 houses, or 50 houses, or 1,000 houses. The proportion of odd-numbered houses will be 50%. But that's not true if your street contains an odd number of houses. For example, if your street contained 3 houses, 1, 2, 3, then 2 of those 3 houses will be odd numbered. If your street contained 5 houses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 3 of those five houses will be odd-numbered. The proportion of odd-numbered houses is slightly more than 50%. And so altogether, the average is tending towards a number greater than 50%. And that's due to streets that contain an odd number of houses. So even though we can now see that the proportion of odd numbered houses is going to be greater than 0.5, justifying why it appears to be 0.502 is going to be more difficult. But roughly speaking, assuming a typical street can range in size from 1 to 1,000, the average proportion of odd numbered houses can be calculated to be 0.502. Now, obviously, there's going to be exceptions to this. There's going to be streets that have more even-numbered houses than odd-numbered houses, or even streets that only have even-numbered houses. But by the same token, there's going to be exceptions in the other direction as well. There are going to be streets that have more odd-numbered houses than even-numbered houses. And I'm going to say that these exceptions are either going to be insignificant or they're going to cancel each other out. Either way, they're going to be drawing the proportion of odd-numbered houses back to 0.502. Now, credit for this goes to my friend Chris Draper, but apart from that, as usual, if you have been, thanks for watching.